Friends, today we will look at how to connect a laptop to a TV. So here's my Windows 10 laptop and here's a TV from the LG brand. So first of all, you need to connect the TV to the power source. So this is the power source. As soon as I switch it on, it will show no signal currently. So first of all, what we need to do is we need to click on the input button on the remote. So as soon as we click on the input, you can look at the TV. Look at all these type of modes. So first mode is the TV mode, which is the antenna mode. So if I click on this, it will show like this. Second mode is the AV1 mode, which is the red, yellow and the white wires. And this is the component mode, which you can see the green, blue, all these inputs. And then you will see a RGB mode. RGB mode is the one which can be used actually to actually connect the PC to the TV using the VGA cables. And then you have HDMI 1 and HDMI 2. So we are not looking at HDMI, but if we actually want to connect through HDMI, we can actually go through HDMI 1 and 2. But right now we will go to RGB. So first of all, select a RGB mode. So we have selected a RGB mode here. Now what we need to do is we need to actually connect our PC using the VGA cable. So this you can see is the VGA cable. It can be like, normally it comes in blue color, but I have a black one. It will have 15 pins, as you can see, 5 on each row, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 and 5, 10 and 15, right? So my laptop, this Lenovo laptop, this is a Yoga series ThinkPad. This does not have a VGA cable. This does not have a VGA pin. So what do I do? So I have bought a converter which can convert from a mini display port. If you look at this sign, there is a small D sign here. So which actually is a mini display port. So I can put a mini display port here into this. Always keep the top where the D sign is mentioned. And then I can actually converting a mini display port to a VGA port, and then I have a cable which will go from this here. I'll just plug this in. Always make sure that the pins are actually correct, because one pin will be on the left more, so always put that more pin on the right, on that side. So this is the right setting. I'll just plug it in. It will go nicely. Just tighten it up and suddenly you will see that it's projecting on my TV, right? Now I'll show you what are the different modes, right? Before that, let me show you what I have done on the back of the TV as well. So let's go back and see. It's the same actually, right? You can see here it's the VGA cable. Let me just show you, it will be mentioned as PC as well. So if you look at it, there will be a PC mentioned here, RGB and PC. So this is the VGA cable which will go in. You can see here the pins are there, 15 pins, right? So just we'll plug it in. And the other modes are here available. We are not using that as of now. And for HDMI, as we had looked earlier, right, in the input modes, we need to plug the HDMI cable here if you are using HDMI. For now, let's put the VGA one. So just put it in and tighten the screws. And then you are all set up. La la la. And you have a 32-inch display here, converted from the 12-inch laptop to a 32-inch. Okay, so now let's look at like how you can personalize, duplicate screen, extend screens and personalize the way you want. So first let me right click and then you can click on display settings. As soon as you click on display settings, the display settings window will open. So just what you can do is first you can identify which screen is what. Like it is showing one and two because two monitors are connected, one the TV and one the laptop. So first do identify, then it will show one and two here. Right, let me do it again. So one is the laptop and two is the TV, right? So it's important to identify this because otherwise we will not know what is happening where. So let's look at like this multiple displays, right? This is very important setting. And there are multiple things here that you can do. One is duplicate these displays, extend, show only on one and only on two. Only on one means it will show only on the laptop because that's the one screen. Only on two meaning it will show only on the TV. So let's look at from the bottom to top. So let me click on show only on two. As soon as I do this, it will ask me to keep changes and it will then start showing only on the TV, right? Now you can see that suddenly the resolution is not looking that great. Why so? Because sometimes what happens is, like as soon as we do this, right, sometimes the resolution does not take it automatically. So what you can do is you can just disconnect the cable once from here and then reconnect it again, and after that it should just show up properly. Let's see.
See now, it shows properly now, this cross and everything is coming up, the resolution is all looking proper, the font is not looking extended or corrupted. So this is one setting where we have just presented only on one, right? And only on two, sorry. Right, so you can see only on two. Nothing is showing on the laptop. So now let's look at other settings. This is so much fun, right? So let me duplicate these displays. So what will duplicate these displays do is, it will show on both of them, right? And keep changes, you should click on that. Now see, it is presenting the same on both of these, right? Now let's look at another setting, which is extend these displays. So extend these displays, what it will do is, it will actually allow you to show one desktop on your laptop and another desktop on your TV. So when you are, let's say, presenting, right, extend displays actually helps, because you don't want to show to people everything what is happening on your laptop, right? If someone is pinging you, some messages are coming, you don't want to show that. So you can see the difference actually, right? If I go on the desktop also, it will be visible. See, the desktop here and the desktop there is very different, right? So this you can use while you are presenting, so that any personal messages or screens are not showing up, right? So now let's change to something which we want. So display settings, and maybe I just want to for now look shown only on two, which is the big screen of TV, right? Because I want to just see it here. See again, keep changes comes up, and I just click on this, and this time the display looks fine, right? So this is one. So you should also look at, right, if this display is not coming out properly for you, you can actually change the display resolution here and here, right? So all that can be done. If you actually choose advanced scaling settings, everything will come up. Also, you can go to advanced display settings, and you can choose display 2, which is the LG TV it is showing me here. And then you can see what is the best resolution which the TV is taking, right? So if you look at it, what is the signal resolution? 1920x1080, right? So you should always keep the resolution like that here. So the resolution should always be like that. It's not coming up here because right now it's showing me frozen. But to actually enable it, what you can do is, you can just do duplicate these displays, and then it will start showing you. See, now it's coming up, right? So maybe possible that for you, it might be choosing the higher resolution, like 2560x1440, but choose the one which is showing up in the advanced display settings. And if you choose that, then your font and everything will look to be perfect. So yeah, we are pretty much done. So today we saw how to connect a TV to a laptop using a VGA cable, right? And if you want to do it for using the HDMI cable, you can just plug in the HDMI cable to the HDMI port in the TV, and that's it. So I hope this helps. If it helps, please subscribe to our channel, and thank you so much for watching. Bye bye.